Hello, friends. My name is Lee Close, and I currently serve as an elder at First Presbyterian Church. During Lent, we are asked to share beliefs which guide us on a daily basis to use as daily devotionals. A guiding belief for me is that God intends us to be unified in Jesus Christ. As Jesus prayed in John 17, 20-23, my prayer is not for them alone. I pray also for those who will believe in me through their message, that all of them may be one, Father, as you are in me and I am in you. May they also be in us, so that the world may believe that you have sent me. I have given them the glory that you gave me, that they may be one as we are one, I in them and you in me. May they be brought to complete unity to let the world know that you sent me and have loved them even as you have loved me. I believe that God has created humankind with the capability to reason and seek understanding, and that we should use this capability to its fullest extent. Our denomination has always understood that the study of God's word would lead to varying interpretation and understanding, and that sincere, faithful people would sometimes disagree. However, we state that insofar as we are able, we should not allow these differences to separate us. I believe deeply in two of our most fundamental Presbyterian principles, freedom of conscience and mutual forbearance. These principles are not always easy to follow, and at times we have found ourselves in disagreement. Still, we are free women and men and should use our freedom of conscience as defined in our Constitution to study and seek God's way. And to the very limits of our internal being, we should bear with each other in this freedom, such that the message and love of Jesus Christ is shown to all people. Again, we seek guidance from the Holy Scriptures and seek to follow the teachings of Jesus, as Paul writes in Ephesians 4:1-3. As a prisoner for the Lord, I urge you to live a life worthy of the calling you have received. Be completely humble and gentle. Be patient, bearing with one another in love. Make every effort to keep the unity of the Spirit through the bond of peace. I believe that as members of the body who have been blessed by Almighty God with substantial resources, we must therefore seek ways in which we can be a blessing to others who are in need. Scripture is clear on this in many places. Most notably for me in Matthew 25:37-40, then the righteous shall answer him, Lord, when did we see you hungry and feed you, or thirsty and give you something to drink? When did we see you a stranger and invite you in, or needing clothes and clothe you? When did we see you sick or in prison and go to visit you? The king will reply, truly I tell you that whatever you did for one of the least of these brothers and sisters of mine, you did for me. And I believe that by seeking opportunities to be a blessing for others, we are fulfilling the instructions given to us by Jesus in the Great Commission, Matthew 28:18-20. All authority in heaven and on earth has been given to me. Therefore, go and make disciples of all nations, baptizing them in the name of the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit, and teaching them to obey everything I have commanded you. And surely I am with you always to the very end of the age. As we seek to follow these teachings of our Lord through worship, discipleship, and mission outreach, we are fulfilling the Great Commission by showing the love of Jesus Christ to others. These are the principles which I try to follow on a daily basis. Let us pray. Father God, may we, as your faithful people, seek to do justice, to love kindness, and walk humbly with you through these days of Lent. In the name of Christ, we pray. Amen.